What's the most I'm turning into my parents moment for you? I've always had a little sass in me, and most of my life, my shyness covered that up. Now I am a one-woman sassica. Thanks, Mom. My brothers have been telling me for years that I am essentially our mom, to the point of calling me little mother, in an endearing way, not a Norman Bates way. I own it. My dad will fall asleep just about anywhere, especially if he sits in recliner. So after I got my first full-time job out of college, I got home and me and my roommate were gonna watch a new episode of some show. I fell asleep in our recliner in less than 10 minutes. I woke up after the show ended and my roommate was like, "Yeah, you were out," and snored a little. When I went from, "Oh hey, this restaurant has live music, cool," to, "Damn it, look at them setting up a drum kit, it's going to be too loud, I can't hear." Sometimes I will say certain words and I'll turn around because I thought my mom said something. It's really scary how me and her share 98% of seemingly random idiosyncrasies. We both talk to ourselves. Full on 45 conversations with ourselves. We both do this, counting this when some of the numbers turn breathy as we count. We both shake our heads and point our fingers the exact same way when we're yelling. Sometimes I'll stop mid-fight because I can see my mom making the exact same motions and it freaks me out. My 10-year-old nephew let me win a video game cause he felt bad for me, like I did to my dad 25 years ago on Super Nintendo. My so and I were packing and getting ready to road trip to some family's house for Thanksgiving. As I was cleaning up the house, my so said something along the lines of, "Don't worry about it, you can clean when we get home." I replied with, "I do not want to come home to a dirty house." At that point I realized I'm turning into my mother. This one. Gotta clean before a trip. My mom used to find things for us in a minute after we had been looking for hours. My siblings and dad sometimes lose things and ask me to help because I always find it magically. I'm actually very excited about the mom touch to finding things. I started dating a mother of four. She has a mom touch on so many levels. And I've for sure abused it. The other day I was on the phone with her and said I couldn't find my iPad. She told me to check under a box I just brought in from my car. She hadn't been over for a couple days, though I was on the phone when I got the box. But, no clue how it works. My dad has away worked himself to death. Now he's retired. When he comes over now, as soon as he sits down on a couch he falls asleep within minutes. I'm noticing couches are starting to have the same effect on me. When I would get irrationally pee off when I would come home at night and see my roommate left a spoon in the sink instead of just washing it real quick. Had a roommate who would always open cabinets and just leave them open. We all despised each other at the end of our lease. Finding myself excited to go to Lowe's. As a child I hated being dragged to that store. As an adult and new homeowner I totally get the appeal of buying power tools and gardening supplies to work on various home improvement projects. It's a great day when you realize you can get out of there for less than $75. My record is like $0.85. I needed a single odd size nut and bolt. I repeat stories. Every time I go home to visit, I'll hear things from my dad that he's either told me by phone already or stories I've heard 100 times. I found that I have also started telling people about stories from my past that I've already told them. Convenient that I don't make up BS, or I'd have to remember all my BS. I remember you telling us about this. My dad was a fairly tall guy. I used to hate walking with him when I was about 4/5 because he'd take giant steps and I had to basically jog everywhere while he dragged my hand. My son is now 4 and I caught myself doing that exact thing about 2 months ago. Now I walk slower. I've always joked that my dad isn't really my father and I'm just a clone of my mom. I look like her, laugh like her, same mannerisms, etc. Then I got the exact same health issues that she has. At the exact same age they began for her. This is a fear of mine since I look and talk and laugh like my mom. But she had a terminal illness and passed away. I can only hope not to repeat that. The good part is I say things sometimes and they remind me of her so much and that makes me happy. The moment I saw a high school picture of me, turns out it was my dad's high school picture. I'm identical to my father and it's annoying as can be. Same. I look just like my old man. baby pics, childhood pics, all the way up to a picture my mom showed me of my 7th birthday party when he was my age now. But good news is, you know what you'll look like when you're older, and can plan accordingly. I went mushroom picking with my friend a couple of months ago. We ended up meeting my dad and granddad also mushroom picking. I'm Polish for clarification, and mushroom picking is like a national sport here. I mostly pick kirki, chanterelles. If your dad and granddad are still at it, you all must know the proper mushrooms to pick. So I'm at IHOP one day, already finished with breakfast, on my second cup of coffee, and the waiter comes with the bill. As I pull out my debit card to pay it, I put my wallet away and think to myself, just let me sit here and enjoy my coffee, which is a phrase that my mother has used so many times at breakfast that she could patent it. I'll admit it does feel nice to just relax and enjoy it instead of rushing out the door as soon as you're done. Now it's something I do routinely. Indeed, I realize I can pay the bill and not leave immediately. It's just this one moment I vividly recall not doing so. Also, I probably should have mentioned that the town I live in is pretty small, and IHOP is usually quite dead most of the time. Otherwise, I wouldn't take it upon myself to make people wait for a table while I'm just there sipping coffee. Let me finish my coffee. Mom proceeds to take the smallest sip of coffee ever to prove that she's still drinking it. Over the course of college, I went from milk and sugar in my coffee to straight black with an espresso shot. I went from ketchup on a lot of things to simply salt and pepper. The sweet tooth turned into a salty savory tooth. This happened to me. I went from a sickeningly sweet and light coffee drinker to preferring just a splash of cream. And my mom would always say how she didn't like pop, soda, and actually preferred water, and I always thought she was lying. Until I got to the age where I don't care for pop. Unless I'm sick, then it's Verner's all the way, and prefer water. Crazy. When me and my first girlfriend broke up, after telling myself I wasn't going to turn into my parents, we broke up because I did all the wrong things my parents do. I dunno if this will help, but I've been told don't focus on what you don't want to be, but focus on what you do. If you spend your time focusing on what you don't want to be, you'll eventually become it. I had a not great dad, and this helps me focus on who I want to be rather than staying in the negatives. Ate at an expensive restaurant and for a sec considered how much better and cheaper it would have been if I made the meal at home. Now I generally try to only order something that I can't make at home, so I can look it up later and find out how much work it would take to learn. I realized I talk exactly like my father. I use the same speech patterns and I don't get to the point, which annoys me as well as anybody listening. Sometimes listening to myself talk is like hearing a sampling of my father's dadisms played back in my mother's voice. I'm basically just a walking character mashup. The first time I told my kids to shut the door, we aren't heating the outside. I finally get why they said it too. It costs money to heat cool the house. My roommate's parents are living with us right now while they get back on their feet financially. We will get home and the heat will be cranked way up because his mom got cold. Just leave the thermostat alone and get a blanket, dammit. I wake up, no alarm, every day at 4 a.m. to get ready for work. Just sit up like clockwork at 4. Never thought I would get to this point. I say the names of things I see while in the car, like, oh, a Burger King and Hummer New Wawa. Interesting. My mom does this and it used to drive me nuts when I was younger. My husband actually types google.com into the search bar, even though our default search engine is Google. It's a classic dad move. While driving in my car, I will put my arm out to protect the passenger if I suddenly stop, even though they are wearing a seat belt. Just like my mom, as the passenger in the front seat, I will step on the brake, even though there is no pedal, the old fake brake, just like my mom does. Having children, the crap that I've said has totally been crap my mom used to say. As a middle-aged male, I am turning into my mother and it terrifies me. Example: I swear to God if I have to go in your room to clean it, it's all going into a garbage bag and being donated to kids that will appreciate it. I came to realization that I have my mother's laugh. As a 23-year-old male, this weirds me out a bit. I didn't notice until I went to her place during a holiday and my brother made both of us laugh. I sounded like her echo. I found a picture of me as a kid with my dad. His Jimmy was in the background. I looked out to my driveway and saw my 99 Chevy Blazer and realized that I was driving pretty much the exact vehicle my dad drove when I was growing up. This wasn't a conscious choice. This is the second Blazer I have owned. His Jimmy was in the background. I thought you meant his Wang was showing in the background of the picture, like a short shorts dad mishap. My girlfriend told me she was cold when we were at home. She was wearing shorts and a tank top. I said, well, put some clothes on. My parents used to say the same thing to me and my sister when we were kids so they wouldn't have to turn the heat up, lol. My wife got a picture of me in shorts that didn't come to my knees, a white tee that I wore under my work shirt, doing dishes, with my headphones in, listening to her podcast. It was a wake-up call I needed. My boyfriend yelled, everyone in the car shut your mouth, when he got frustrated in a busy parking lot. It was just the two of us in the car and I wasn't talking. The mental image of this is hysterically funny to me. I was always annoyed my parents could never remember the names of the toys and other things I wanted. My mom especially would butcher the names, once calling G.I. Joe Jojo dolls. I now realize it's freaking hard to remember the names of all the crap my kids want. Called an LOL doll collectible a freaking lowly doll at the checkout line. Cringed so hard. Me complaining about my dad. Crap, I'm just like my mom. Me complaining about my mom. Crap, I'm just like my dad. Me complaining to myself about myself. Crap, I'm just like my parents. My dad is always pulling any weeds he sees in the grass or on his driveway. I caught myself doing this for about 20 minutes before it hit me. Mother used to drive me nuts with her "I can't sleep if the house is messy." Guess who was half drunk cleaning and taking down the tree after a night party until 3 a.m. Christ, where to freaking begin? I find myself tucking in my shirts for the warmth. I've collected a tremendous amount of Mickey Mouse decor without even realizing it was happening. I find myself saying "my goodness gracious" all the time. My father says this, never cusses. Up until a few years ago I had an embarrassingly vile mouth. I've become more and more cynical about our local sports team's ownership and find myself ignoring good sense analysis and wanting them to get a guy who can just go out there and win. I bought a digital TV antenna just to watch repeats of Emergency. I now own multiple pairs of jorts. I reinstalled and put like 40 hours into Blow Bites the Settlers 2. I was really excited to get a measuring tape for Christmas. I referred to a signing competition show as appointment viewing. I had a talk with our neighbors because their kids keep getting into our yard while playing football and they trample through my planter. Felt weird doing that since I'm 26 years old and their dad had 2 decades on me. I installed next door, but not for trolling. This is all fairly benign, but altogether I am a very boring married 20-something. Comma, I now own multiple pairs of jorts. This isn't benign at all. I was demolishing a wall in my house and decided to have a beer part way through. Upon taking down some part of it, I found an empty Corona in there from my dad 25 years ago when he put up the sheetrock. Parents were going on a boat trip. I sent them a text that said, have fun, wear life jackets. Didn't even realize what I'd done until afterwards. It was admittedly right after that duck boat disaster, but still the most mom thing I've ever done. My dad used to come and stand behind the sofa wearing an apron whilst I was watching TV, and put his hands on his hips and watch a bit of whatever was on whilst he was waiting for something to cook. I now do exactly the same thing in my flat with my girlfriend when I'm cooking and she's watching TV. I use whilst. I'm British. I can only apologize for my nationality. My dad does not wear an apron, but if he is cooking he always has a tea towel over his shoulder and that's how you know he means business. I can only hope that I turn into my father. That man is the most amazing, fantastic guy I've ever known. He worked his butt off to make my childhood as magical as it possibly could be. For my birthday every year, he told me that the fairies would help me celebrate. He had me shove sticks into the ground outside, and he would always switch them out for my favorite flowers. One or two of them were always those fake roses with chocolate flowers. The fairies would also always leave me a pinata. It would usually be a sun, doused in glitter, and would always be left on our big tree in the backyard. Inside were all my favorite candies, and a toy wrapped in green wrapping paper. For Christmas, He would leave special handwritten notes from Santa Claus, and even paid our neighbor, who had a horse, to leave hoof prints in the snow outside. On the days leading up to St. Patrick's Day, we would construct a leprechaun trap. I'd wake up only to find tiny footprints everywhere, and a pile of gold dollars. They were always too sneaky for us to catch. On Easter, the bunny would always leave me presents, and lots of eggs. But aside from all these super awesome things my dad did for me, there were bigger, more meaningful things he was always sure to do. For example, he always made sure that I feel heard. If ever I have a problem, he listens. He doesn't always have advice, but he's there, and that's what is most important. It didn't matter if the problem seemed small to him, because he knew it was big to me. He's always been one of my best friends, there for advice when I need it, for a hug or a shoulder to cry on. Heck, he did some truly silly things that I know he got teased for. I can distinctly remember him letting me paint his nails before work, which looked silly f. My dad is about 6'2", and at the time, was easily 200 pounds. But he went above and beyond all that. He taught me self-defense. He was a boxer back in the day. He taught me how to deal with anger and sadness in a healthy way. He also made it very clear that if anyone touched me, he'd kill them. He was my rock. He both kept me grounded and encouraged me to soar. He nurtured my creative side and encouraged my scientific one as well. I want to be exactly that for my son. I never want him to question whether or not I love him, whether or not he can come to me for absolutely anything. I have done my dead level best to drill into my child that there is nothing he can ever do to make me stop loving him, that I will always protect him, that anything he says to me will die with me, that his problems and concerns are never too small or too big for me to help with. I really hope that one day I have that holy crap, I'm my father moment. I was in the middle of yelling at my boyfriend about what was essentially nothing when I realized that how I was shouting sounded like my father. I realized I'd inherited my father's anger, the way he bottled it in, the way he lashed out at the ones he loved. So much rage and so much unhealthy expression of it, so much inherent need for violence. Nowadays I'm trying to be more patient. I'm trying to walk away, count to 10, breathe, and I'm looking up kickboxing classes. I'm not ending up bitter and lovable and alone, and I will not hurt the people I love the way he did. Oh, if this hit hard, could have written this myself. My parents recently split up, mostly from my mom getting fed up with this, and it really threw my own actions into light. I'm lucky my boyfriend has been able to get through it until now and support me as I work through learning to be better. I work in the same profession as my dad and unknowingly got the same position he had 10 years ago at the same company he worked for. I go to bed at 8:30 and wake up at 4:30 and my first stop is turn on the coffee pot every single morning even when I'm off, and all of this never dawned on me until my mother pointed it out when I was home for Christmas. Leaving notes and labeling things in the kitchen for my housemates. Didn't even think twice about it until they pointed out that it was cute that I did it. Definitely got that from my mom SMH. We are a military family, and we thus have moved around a bit. 2 houses ago, we broke out the label maker and labeled all the light switches in the house, and all the cupboards and drawers in the kitchen. Then we did it again in the next house, and the current one. Every time I try to explain something or correct something, I catch myself running around in circles repeating what I just said over and over. I always hated that when my dad did it, because it comes off like you don't believe the listener has enough capacity to understand you from the first time. Tell people to slow down when they drive too fast in my neighborhood. I don't even have kids, but it scares the crap out of me that one, the kids will get killed. I gave a guy I dated the "no one owes you crap, earn it" speech about job hunting. I got that speech at age 13, 17, 21 and 23. Felt weird giving it to a 37-year-old. My dad was always digging himself into holes with his dad jokes, but he's passed that shovel onto me. The realization was groundbreaking. When I realized that I was becoming a compassionate, sympathetic, caring and loving human being, and that I had my mom's influence to thank for all of it. Love you, Mom. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.